One of you is asking, what is IAOR? So IAOR stands for your instantaneous axis of rotation. So you might have seen that whenever, I can take doubts again towards the end of the lecture. All right. So IAOR is, I can take doubts towards the end of class. All right. IAOR is, it stands for the instantaneous axis of rotation. Yeah, pe niche likha hai. Yeah, specifically, if you want to use this torque equation, is the inertial axis of rotation. Matlab, ek aisa axis jiska acceleration zero hai. Ab typically, your fixed axis ka acceleration zero rahega. Why do I make a big deal about this? Is because jabhi bhi tum ye relation use karte ho, alpha is torque upon I. Yeah, in other words, torque is equal to I alpha. I want everyone to be then very clear ki ye hamesha kaam nahi karta hai. This only works for two axes of a body. It works about the center of mass. Torque about center of mass is ICM alpha. And it also works about an axis jiska acceleration zero hai. Okay? Jiska acceleration zero hai. So wo axis jiska acceleration zero hai, that's what I call as the inertial axis of rotation. Yeah? Instantaneous axis of rotation. Normally they both normally are the same. And in simple terms, that is just the axis which is fixed. Your body may be rotating about some fixed axis. Us axis ke about, you can apply torque equal to I alpha and it will work. Okay? You can't apply about any random axis. You can apply about the fixed axis or you can apply about your center of mass. So that's why I keep giving that subscript. Okay? So it will be drilled in your head and you won't make any conceptual mistake later on. So I'll give a quick recap of how angular SHM is similar to linear SHM, and then we proceed from there. Yes, Prithvi, yes. So the angular SHM, linear SHM, mein you have these terms, displacement, velocity, acceleration, hai na? Ek sine function, ek cos function, ek wapas negative sine function. Wohi teen term ke jagah, angular displacement, angular velocity, jisko psi se represent karenge, bas is chapter ke liye, and angular acceleration. Okay, so those terms x, b, and a get replaced by theta, psi, and alpha. K and omega have the same meaning. Omega is rate of change of phase. K is spring constant. Amplitude is the max value of x. Theta naught is the max value of theta. So theta naught is angular amplitude. Okay, phase has the same meaning. Same meaning. So extreme positions pe 90 degrees and 270 degrees. Mean position pe 0 and 180 degrees. Delta is initial phase, that is phase at t equal to 0. Okay, so our equation x is a sine omega t plus delta. Your a sine phase over here becomes theta is theta not sine phase. The theta is angular amplitude sine phase. Again, so correspondingly, you can convert v is a omega cos phase. I never memorize this, I always convert. V is a omega cos phase. So angular velocity is angular amplitude omega cos phase. Very similar. Acceleration is minus a omega square sine phase. Angular acceleration is minus theta naught omega square sine phase. V is omega root a square minus x square. Psi is omega root theta naught square minus theta square. Okay, so there's a similarity here. We went over this in the previous class. T is 2 pi root m by k ke jagah, yahan pe m ke jagah moment of inertia. Okay, about which axis? IAOR. There is going to be a fixed axis about which the body is rotating. Us axis ke about moment of inertia. Okay, I to alag alag axis ke liye alag alag hota na. So, kis axis? Jis axis ke about body ghum raha. Okay, phir F and M ke jagah torque I hai tumhare paas. Theek hai? And then again, torque and I about that fixed axis. Omega is root k by m, omega is root k by i. I added in these last three terms today morning. So U, potential energy is half kx square in a linear SHM. Yahan pe potential energy will be half k theta square. Okay, potential energy will be half k angular displacement square. Kinetic energy is half mv square. Hai na? For a linear SHM, kinetic energy of a rotating body. Kya yaad hai? Half I angular velocity square. Half I about the fixed axis, angular velocity square. That is your formula. Right? So half I psi square is going to be kinetic energy in angular SHM. And when you add them up, total energy half k a square aata tha. Waise hi yahan pe total energy half k max angle theta naught square hai. So every formula that you've seen for linear SHM can be converted to the corresponding angular SHM terms. Okay. So I am guessing you've written all of this, and all you had to do was you had to add these three terms as well, which I guess you guys have done. Okay. So I think I'm going to move on then to the next page. So we're going to talk about a torsional spring. Okay. Just the way we visualize a normal spring block system as the simplest example of a linear SHM, waisa hi a torsional spring can be considered the simplest example of an angular SHM. So torsional spring is basically a spring which resists being twisted. It doesn't like being twisted. So it can be actually any material. It can be a metallic wire. It can be a string, a cotton string. It can be a rubber wire. It can be anything. A rubber string. All these things will resist being twisted. All materials have a, if you remember in properties of matter, all materials have a shear modulus or a torsional modulus. They don't like their shape being deformed. If somebody tries to deform their shape, they'll try to come back to their original shape. So you can imagine hanging a small disc from a piece of thread. Okay. Imagine the disc looks like this, a small disc from a piece of thread. And you try rotating the disc, rotate the disc some 10, 15 times and release it. You'll see the disc starts to rotate in the opposite direction. Why is that happening? That piece of thread simply didn't like being twisted. So it again, try to become straight. Okay. So a torsional spring is something like that, which resists a material, which resists being twisted. Now, for a torsional spring, you'll typically find ki if the material is twisted by an angle theta, it will apply a torque equal to minus k theta. Minus q is going to apply a restoring torque. Okay, so for instance, if you are going to rotate, imagine this is a torsional spring जिसके नीचे हमने एक प्लेट डाल दिया और मान लो हम इस प्लेट को थीटा एंगल से ऊपर से क्या देख रहा है एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन में घुमा रहा है ठीक है थीटा इक्वल टू जीरो सम रेफरेंस लाइन ये एक लाइन को कलर करके रखेंगे ताकि हमें समझ में आ रहा है कितने से वो डिस्क रोटेट हो रहा है इफ आई डोंट कलर एनी लाइन ऑन द डिस्क एंड इफ द डिस्क इज जस्ट प्योर व्हाइट आई वोंट कम टू नो हाउ मच आई हैव रोटेटेड बाय सो आई एम जस्ट हाईलाइटिंग द रेडियस And then I'm rotating the disc by an angle theta. So accordingly, I can see that radius also rotate by an angle theta. Now, when I rotate this by an angle theta, we'll find ki jo torsional spring tha, wo ek restoring torque is disc pe lagayega. And that restoring torque is going to be proportional to theta. And that constant of proportionality is going to be k. Where k can be called as the torsional spring constant. Or if you want, you can just call it normal. You can just say spring constant as well. Okay? But technically, it'll be the torsional spring constant. So, aisa ek torque proportional to theta lagta hai. And if you treat them as vectors and you take, you know, define a positive axis and all that, then torque will become minus k theta because its direction is opposite that of theta. It's opposing the change. Theta anti-clockwise, the torque clockwise disc ko ghumane ki koshish kare. Okay. And potential energy for a torsional spring is going to be half k theta square, which is on the previous page as well. Okay. Nee, this is just a this this need not be like a coiled spring. This can be this just can be any cylindrical object. Koi bhi cylindrical object le lo, it does not like being twisted. It can be a simple metallic wire as well. Metallic wire se ek disc ko suspend kar lo aur wo disc ko ghumaoge na to then ghuma ke chodo wo metallic wire disc ko ulta ghumana start karega. I hope we can visualize that happen. Then happening. Yeah, the red line is the axis. So the red line is the instantaneous axis of rotation because that axis is fixed. So uske about, jabhi bhi hum torque ke bare mein baat karenge, we are talking about torque about that axis. Uske about torque is k theta lage. For the disc. और वो स्प्रिंग लगाएगा, ठीक है? The spring will have some thickness. It's not just going to be a thin. It will have some thickness. It will be like a cylinder. And if you twist that cylinder, it will retaliate. Just, I mean, for instance, my experience is just take your hair and twist it. Your hair will again take a small lump of hair and just twist it and release your hair. It'll again become straight. Unless your hair is too curly, thoda to at least it'll try to bounce back to its original shape. So all materials resist being twisted. Yeah, a torsion spring is what is used in a car. In a steering wheel, you rotate the steering wheel, maybe clockwise, and you release the steering wheel. It's going to again become straight. Okay. Of course, the mechanism is a little bit more complex. It brings it back to the mean position. But it then suddenly somehow, you know, it stops it. It doesn't let it go to the other side. There is some kind of stopper. It will bring it back to the mean position, but won't let it go cross over to the other side. So steering wheel ko ghumao aur chhod do, it will come back to the mean position and then stop with a jerk. There's something there to prevent it from further rotating. But yeah, that's a torsional spring in action. Yeah, so aage questions aage dikhega. This is just the model behind an angular assist. Okay. Let me know if you're done with this page. So with the torsional spring, we can talk about a torsional pendulum. So spring is just the pink part. Okay. But the pink part plus the disc or the pink part plus any object underneath it becomes a torsional pendulum. Okay. So then the entire thing, the string and then the disc becomes a torsional pendulum. Okay, little. And then questions can be asked, iska time period kya hoga? And iska, time period basically kya hoga? Disc ka mean position, angular velocity kya hoga? Any such question can be asked. Of course, now since this is the most basic example of an angular SHM, tumhara time period ka formula waisa hi dikhega jo humne pichle page mein dekha. So yahan pe torsional pendulum is the string, the spring plus the disc. Okay, cool. So let's say in different situations, you will be asked to find the moment of inertia. Maybe, you know, you will have to figure out the moment of inertia of whatever object is there. That object could be anything. It could be a disc. It could be a semicircular disc, or it could be, you know, it could be a sphere, hemisphere. It could be anything. So you have to find the moment of inertia of whatever object is placed over there. Okay? And then once you have that, then torque is equal to minus k theta. Okay? So we know ki isko kaise bhi rotate karenge, koi bhi angle se rotate karenge, torque opposing nature ka hoga. The torque is minus k theta, which tells us ki this is an angular SHM. In fact, this is the most basic example of an angular SHM. फिर उस डिस्क का एंगुलर एक्सेलरेशन होगा टॉर्क अपॉन आई, ठीक है, और रिमेंबर द सबस्क्रिप्ट, टॉर्क अबाउट द फिक्स्ड एक्सिस अपॉन आई अबाउट द फिक्स्ड एक्सिस. तो अल्फा इज गोइंग टू बी टॉर्क अपॉन आई, व्हिच इज गोइंग टू मेक दिस माइनस के बाय आई थीटा, व्हिच इज गोइंग टू मेक ओमेगा रूट के बाय आई, ठीक है. और फिर वहां से यू कैन गेट योर टाइम पीरियड एज 2 पाई बाय ओमेगा, मतलब ओमेगा का रेसिप्रोकल इनटू 2 पाई, तो टाइम पीरियड आ जाएगा. एंड आई कैन बी डिफरेंट बेस्ड ऑन यू नो डिफरेंट सिचुएशंस. फॉर इंस्टेंस इफ दिस इज अ डिस्क, इट विल बी यू नो एम आर स्क्वायर बाय 2. इफ द सेम डिस्क इज हंग लाइक दिस एंड इसको ऐसा घुमा रहे, ऐसा ट्विस्ट करके, व्हाट डू आई शो इट, ऐसा, हो वाओ, ऐसा ट्विस्ट करके रिलीज किया है, तो इस केस में क्या टाइम पीरियड होगा ऐसे डिस्क के लिए? No, Rugve, that's not the reason. That's not the reason. There is a spring which makes the steering wheel, spring mechanism which makes the steering wheel become straight again. It doesn't have to do with the road. Even if your wheels are not on the road, like if your vehicle is in some kind of garage where the wheels are in the air, even if you rotate the steering wheel and release it, it will become straight again. And it's an inbuilt design mechanism. Okay. Yes, yes, saying it. यहाँ पे क्या है, यहाँ पे अगर ये एक स्ट्रिंग है और एक प्लेट को मैंने ऐसा, I hope I can draw that thing again. If I hang a plate like this, okay, so if this is my spring and this time I hang a plate like this, so based on the situation you will get, you know, different moments of inertia, and then accordingly you'll have different time periods. Yeah, so isko aisa ghumaya, iska spring constant hai k, is situation mein time period, disc ka mass, disc has mass m, so disc ko mass m and radius. So all depends on the moment of inertia. So I can really hang anything. I can hang a ball like that. I can hang a semicircle like this. So typically, एक बार ये निपटा देता हूँ. क्या आएगा इसका time period? So this time, है ना, this is your instantaneous axis of rotation. Okay, what is this disc rotating about? Isn't it rotating about this kind of axis? So is axis ke about tumhe moment of inertia chahiye? Yes, chahiye. Is axis ke about moment of inertia chahiye? So tumhara time period hoega 2 pi root. What is the moment of inertia of a disc about its diameter? Perpendicular axis theorem se yaad, mr square by 2 ka aadha. mr square by 4 आ जाएगा, तो 2 pi root mr square by 4 divided by k, 2 pi root I by k. So those are the kinds of questions you can get in this. Of course, 4 बार आके 2 को कैंसिल करें. Yeah, shall I talk about that? Just hold on to that. We'll visit a pendulum again. So that's actually 2 pi root L by G. What you're writing as acceleration means acceleration due to gravity, a G effective. And one of you saying, sir, kya isme aisa dono ka combination ho sakta hai kya? Matlab angular SHM ke saath saath linear SHM bhi kara sakta hai. Matlab isko aisa ghuma ke ऐसा साइड से रिलीज करके भी किया जा सकता है. ऑफ कोर्स थियोरेटिकली किया जा सकता है. they won't ask a question on that, or even if they ask, these two motions will be independent. ये ऐसा रोटेट करने का एक अलग टाइम पीरियड होगा और इसका ऐसा ऐसा मोशन का एक अलग टाइम पीरियड होगा. ऐसा ऐसा मोशन का टाइम पीरियड हम देखने वाले, ठीक है, फॉर इट टू ऑसिलेट लाइक दिस, उसका एक टाइम पीरियड देखेंगे. That's called as a physical pendulum. But the two things will be independent. Yeah, so they won't ask on the basis of that. I mean, but the motions will be independent. And it may not even be synchronized. हो सकता है ये ऐसा oscillate करे every 4 seconds. हो सकता है इसका motion हो, है ना, ये ऐसा rotate करे every 3 seconds. The motion need not even be synchronized. Yeah, I'm just telling you from a like a real world point of view. You can have as a complex pendulum type motion. So we won't do anything like that. But... Got it? There it'll just be a combination of these two. मतलब ये ऐसा ऐसा घूमने के साथ साथ फिर अपने एक्सिस के ऊपर रोटेट करते करते वो ऑसिलेट भी कर सकता है थियोरेटिकली. Okay, done with this page. Simple as any, based on any object I hang from that string, if I twist it, okay, copy kar lo. If I twist it and twist karke, then I release and I ask you to find time period, you'll do something like this. Okay. हाँ, I'll explain the last example once more. क्या है ये फॉर्मूला, देखो दिस इज 2 पाई रूट आई बाई के. आई कौन सा है, आई इज अबाउट द एक्सिस जिसके अबाउट ये रोटेट कर रहा है. तो यहाँ पे मैंने क्या किया है, यहाँ पे दिस इज डिस्क, ओके, एंड दिस डिस्क इज एज यू कैन सी आगे से देखते हैं तो सर्कल दिखता है. सो दिस इज लाइक द फ्रंट व्यू ऑफ अ डिस्क और अ व्हील, ठीक है. तो इसको एक पॉइंट से हैंग किया है और इसको ऐसा घुमाया, ठीक है, लाइक व्हेन आई एम रोटेटिंग दिस, दिस पार्ट इज कमिंग टुवर्ड्स यू, दिस पार्ट इज गोइंग अवे फ्रॉम यू. तो ऐसा घुमाया कॉजिंग अ ट्विस्ट इन दैट टॉर्शनल स्प्रिंग. नाउ एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस, व्हेन जब इसको ऐसा घुमा के रिलीज करोगे तो ये ऐसा ऐसा आगे पीछे ऑसिलेट करते जाएगा, ठीक है. यू कैन इमेजिन दैट हैपन, आई होप. तो ऐसा आगे पीछे ऑसिलेट करेगा, उसका टाइम पीरियड पूछा था. तो ऑल यू नीड टू डू इज 2 पाई रूट इस एक्सिस, जिस एक्सिस के अबाउट वो घूम रहा है, उस एक्सिस के अबाउट मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया बाय के. अब उस एक्सिस के अबाउट मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया, आई मीन दैट एक्सिस बिकम्स द डायमीटर ऑफ अ डिस्क. तो ऑल वी डिड वाज वी यूज द फॉर्मूला फॉर द डायमीटर ऑफ अ डिस्क. मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया ऑफ द डायमीटर ऑफ अ डिस्क इज एम आर स्क्वायर बाय 4. तो वो फॉर्मूला यूज. If it was a sphere, we would have used 2 by 5 mR square. Solid sphere ke liye, hollow sphere ke liye 2 by 3 mR square. Yeah, so if you know your moment of inertia formulas, you can do these questions. Got it? Now, abhi we'll just revisit a simple pendulum, okay, once more. And we'll see ki simpler pendulum can also be seen as an angular SHM. Think about it. Simple pendulum में ये particle तो एक छोटा सा linear SHM कर रहा है along this arc, but साथ साथ particle एक ये पूरा, in fact this entire particle can also be considered to be performing an angular SHM about that axis of rotation. You can even imagine this entire body, in fact, performing an angular SHM about that axis of rotation. Yeah? You rotate it through some angle theta towards the in an anti-clockwise manner, and you release it from there, it starts oscillating like this. So it's also seeming to perform an angular SHM about the IOR. So in fact, a simple pendulum can be visualized both ways, linear SHMB, angular SHMB, and either way say time period exactly same aega. Either approaches say time period exactly same aega. They are just two different ways of viewing the same thing. So क्या है, like before, let's say we have a bob of mass m and light string, and we displace the pendulum by an amount x, okay, and then we release the pendulum. Okay, so once we release the pendulum, string ka length hoga l, maan lo. So at any instant, we want to find torque about the IAOR. Okay, torque acting on this system. So if you consider the forces acting on this system, you have tension. Tension ek to internal force ho gaya, and even if you only take the ball, then tension passes through the axis. So tension ka to torque aayega hi nahi. Yeah, so then the only thing that jiska torque actually IAOR ke about aayega will be mg. Alright, gravity ka torque at any instant when the angle is theta. So for that you need to take mg into the lever arm. Yeah, mg into perpendicular distance. Wo perpendicular distance ho jayega l sine theta. The torque about the IAOR will become mg l sine theta. Okay. Now don't worry about the minus sign. The minus sign is just when you take an axis and you define theta to be positive, then torque automatically will become negative. Now both have different directions. One is anti-clockwise, the other is clockwise. So torque, bas us karan ek minus sign aa raha. If you in fact now apply the approximation, this filal is not an SHF, but when we apply the approximation ki theta chota hai, like before, then suddenly when you make sine theta equal to theta, then this becomes an angular SHM. Torque is proportional to theta. Pehle humne kiya tha, force is proportional to x. Now I'm proving torque is proportional to theta. They're very similar. And the minus sign is there because torque and theta have opposite signs. But this relation is enough to prove that this motion is an angular SHM. Is motion ke liye, ab alpha jab nikaloge, to alpha is torque about that axis upon moment of inertia about that axis. And think, moment of inertia of the pendulum about the topmost point kya hoga. So you have a massless string jiska kuch nahi hoga, and then you have what can be considered a point object. The point object r distance, l distance away from the axis, you have a moment of inertia of m l square. So moment of inertia about that axis becomes m l square. So dhyan se aa jayega ki alpha is m or l kaat do, alpha is minus g by l theta, omega square is g upon l, omega square is g upon l, so omega ho jayega root g by l, proving once again time period is 2 pi root l upon g. All right, so that it's just another way of seeing the same thing. How is it an angular SHM? Once more, Q, look at this line. Rotate this through theta. So when I rotate the system through an angle theta, what we are getting is, when I rotate the system through an angle theta, the torque it experiences should be proportional to theta. Did I not prove that? Torque is proportional to theta. Therefore, it is an angular SHM. Or visualize ho raha hai, ye angular oscillation kar raha hai, ye line, ye radius dekho. Radius us taraf ja raha hai, fir lot ke is taraf ja raha hai, fir. So, angle bhi oscillate ho raha hai na. Uska angular position change ho raha hai. It's not just the ball's position changing along this arc. The entire thing can be seen as though it is rotating about this axis. Thoda anti-clockwise, thoda clockwise, anti-clockwise. So it's performing an angular oscillation as well. Okay? And thoda mathematical analysis will show ki it's an angular SHM and time period comes out to be exactly the same. Any doubts? Why is it minus mg l sine theta? How do we find torque? So I'm just taking one direction to be positive. Okay, I've taken anti-clockwise to be positive. Okay, so torque is in the opposite sense, which is why a minus sign is appearing. But how do I get this magnitude? What is mg ka torque? Mg ka, ha, mg ka torque ho jayega mg into perpendicular distance from the IOR. So mg l sine theta. All right, good. Okay, now just bear in mind ki a couple of extra points. Just remember ki if you're in any alternate, some extra points. Remember ki the actual formula can be looked upon as 2 pi root L by G effective. Okay, so if you're in any accelerating vessel, okay, you're in a, let's say you're in a car, or let's say you're in an elevator, hai na, to us case mein time period kya ho jayega? L upon G effective. Or let's say you, as you might have seen in gravitation, if you go into the surface of the earth, or you go move away from the surface of the earth, G is going to change. So accordingly, you have to adjust G. Or L be na, L is distance between, you can say L is distance between, if the ball is slightly big, then you'll say L is distance between center, yes, distance between the center of mass of the ball and the point of suspension. Distance between the center of mass of the ball and the point of suspension. Okay, so like for instance, if it's just a if the ball's radius has been given, then what will you take length as? Agar iska radius diya hai, L plus R. Just remember these finer points. You take it as L plus R. And iska logic hai, wo derivation mein jab main torque likhunga, तो टॉर्क एक्चुअली सेंटर ऑफ मास पे एक्ट करता है ना, इट्स टॉर्क इज एक्चुअली एक्टिंग ऑन द सेंटर ऑफ मास. सो व्हेन आई ट्राई टू राइट द टॉर्क ऑफ ग्रेविटी, आई मीन ग्रेविटी इज एक्टिंग ऑन द सेंटर ऑफ मास इफेक्टिवली. सो व्हेन आई ट्राई टू राइट द टॉर्क ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी, इट्स गोइंग टू बी एल प्लस आर साइन थीटा इंस्टेड ऑफ एल साइन थीटा. इसलिए है ना, द इम्पोर्टेंट डिस्टेंस इज सेंटर ऑफ मास का डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ सस्पेंशन. जब बॉब छोटा रहता है, वी इग्नोर दैट आर. एंड अनदर पीस ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन, अ सेकेंड पेंडुलम, आई थिंक आई मेंशन दिस इन हीट ट्रांसफर, बट जस्ट टू रिवाइज, व्हाट इज द टाइम पीरियड ऑफ अ सेकेंड पेंडुलम? Very nice. Yeah. Okay. So a second pendulum has a time period of 2 seconds. Remember that. Wo ek end se dusra end ek second mein jata. So jo bhi ding dong ya tick tock. Okay. Ek taraf ding, dusri taraf dong. So, I mean, 1 second it takes to go from one extreme to the other extreme. To ek pura oscillation ke liye wo 2 second leta. Is the piece of trivia. R is the radius of the bob. M and R are mass and radius of the bob. So center se distance technically becomes L plus R. L plus R. लिखिए। ठीक, नाउ टू द मोर फन पार्ट, वी हैव समथिंग कॉल्ड एज अ फिजिकल पेंडुलम, वेयर व्हाट दैट बेसिकली इज कि नाउ आई कैन टेक एनी ऑब्जेक्ट, ठीक है, एनी ऑब्जेक्ट, अ डिस्क, अ बॉल, अ कोन, एनी ऑब्जेक्ट आई कैन हैंग सस्पेंड फ्रॉम वन पॉइंट एंड देन यू नो ऑफ कोर्स व्हेन वी सस्पेंड इट फ्रॉम सम पॉइंट इट विल बी इन इक्विलिब्रियम इन सम पोजिशन एंड यू ऑल नो कि दैट पोजिशन इज व्हेन The center of mass is exactly below the so any random object अगर मैंने ऐसा hang किया तो वो जब finally equilibrium में रहेगा what can I tell about the center of mass where is the center of mass in the final equilibrium position of that object you might have seen this in rotational mechanics ऐसे ही कुछ भी object को hang करोगे तो कैसे भी हैंग करके छोड़ो बाय द टाइम इट फाइनली सेटल्स डाउन इट विल सेटल इन अ पोजिशन वेयर द सेंटर ऑफ मास इज वर्टिकली बिलो द पॉइंट ऑफ सस्पेंशन ऑलवेज ठीक है ऑलवेज विल सेटल इन अ पोजिशन वेयर द सेंटर ऑफ मास इज वर्टिकली बिलो द पॉइंट ऑफ सस्पेंशन बिकॉज तुम है ना इन दैट केस टॉर्क ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी जीरो इक्विलिब्रियम मतलब नो टॉर्क सेंटर मास साइड में रहेगा तो टॉर्क रहेगा और ये घूमेगा बट सेंटर मास एग्जैक्टली नीचे रहेगा तो टॉर्क नहीं रहेगा है ना एवरीवन नोज दिस है ना ओके सो लाइक फॉर इंस्टेंस इफ आई हैंग अ बॉल वी ऑल नो कि बॉल का इक्विलिब्रियम पोजीशन है वेयर द बॉल इज एग्जैक्टली बिलो द पॉइंट ऑफ सस्पेंशन एंड नॉट समवेयर लाइक दिस बट यू नो व्हाट इफ यू हैव समथिंग एल्स व्हाट इफ यू हैव अ वियर्ड शेप्ड ऑब्जेक्ट Then in that case, you can rest assured ki center of mass jab uske niche hoga, that's where the object will be in equilibrium. Now, isko fir agar main thoda displace karke chhod do, disturb karke chhod do, to ye aisa 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 oscillate karega. That kind of oscillation, okay, when it performs that kind of oscillation, we'll call it a physical pendulum. Okay, so what's going to be fun is we can find the time period of any such पेंडुलम कोई भी ऑब्जेक्ट को कोई भी एक होल बना के उसको हैंग किया सस्पेंड किया और फिर उसको ऐसे थोड़ा स्विंग कराया तो उसका स्विंगिंग मोशन का टाइम पीरियड हम निकाल सकते हैं ठीक है सो दैट प्रोसेस आई मीन डूइंग दैट व्हेन एन ऑब्जेक्ट लाइक दैट स्विंग्स टू एंड फ्रो इट्स कॉल्ड एज अ फिजिकल पेंडुलम और अ कंपाउंड पेंडुलम ओके बोथ नेम्स आर वन एंड द सेम refer to the same thing physical pendulum or compound pendulum what is it any object suspended from a point free to rotate about it so any object ko koi bhi point se suspend kar lo theek hai and fir usko swing karao uska time period small oscillations ke liye uska jo time period aayega small oscillations ke liye that, I mean that is called a physical pendulum and uska time period nikalne ka ek formula derive karenge And then with that formula, you can be asked any question and you have to accordingly substitute the moment of inertia. So let's see. ये है मान लो एक कोई तो एक random सा object है. As I mentioned, when will that object, what will be the position of that object? How will that object look if you leave it for a long time? If you allow it to come to rest? It has to look like this where its center mass is exactly below the IOR. Did everyone get that? Because only अब इस situation में gravity का torque zero है और gravity इसको disturb नहीं कर रहा है अगर center of mass यहाँ पे होता तो gravity का torque इसको इस axis के about घुमा देता So the equilibrium position is where when the center of mass is exactly below the point of suspension. Okay. Now if I rotate this by an angle theta, how do we approach? How do we find time period? Yaad karo, linear SHM mein kya karte the? We displace by a small amount from the equilibrium position, and then we find restoring force, and see if it's proportional to x. Yaha pe same cheez. Bas ulta kya karenge? We'll rotate by a small angle, and we'll find restoring torque. We'll find the change in the torque. पहले तो टॉर्क जीरो ही था इसको थोड़ा सा रिस्टोर थीटा से रोटेट किया तो सिर्फ अब एमजी का टॉर्क चेंज हो रहा है, कितने से एमजी का टॉर्क चेंज हो रहा है, देखो एज इट रोटेट्स बाय एंगल थीटा सेंटर ऑफ मास वाला पॉइंट इधर आ जाएगा. ओके, लेट एल इन दिस डायग्राम डिनोट द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द सेंटर ऑफ मास एंड द IAOR. व्हाट इज द IAOR? द फिक्स्ड एक्सिस, जहां से इसको टंगा है. तो एल, लेट एल रिप्रेजेंट द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन सेंटर ऑफ मास एंड दैट IAOR. इसको थीटा से रोटेट करोगे तो सेंटर ऑफ मास इधर होगा. Gravity for torque purposes can be assumed to act at the center of mass. So let's say mg is acting at the center of mass. Now mg ka torque about that axis, same story like before. Ye wapas l hai, wo wapas ye angle fir se theta hai. To ye jo perpendicular distance aayega will be l sin theta. Mg ka lever arm ho jayega l sin theta. So torque fir se about that IAOR will be minus mg l sin theta. Why is it minus? Only because it's in the opposite sense. Theta ko is direction mein positive liya, fir torque, because torque opposite direction mein aa raha hai, restoring torque aa raha hai, torque is getting a minus sign. Okay, so minus mg l sin theta, making it minus mg l theta when theta is small. Okay, theta is small. Yahan pe we are going to make the assumption ki theta is small. For this purpose. अब prove हो गया कि torque theta के proportional है. Now alpha is torque upon I. Alpha is torque upon I, making this minus mgl theta, minus mgl theta upon I. Okay, तो I भी कौन सा, उस axis के about I. तो now alpha आ गया ऐसा. अब alpha में theta के सामने जो चीज होता है वो होता है omega square. टाइम पीरियड होता है 2π/ओमेगा. मतलब इस चीज का रूट लेना पड़ेगा तो ओमेगा आएगा, और फिर उसका रेसिप्रोकल लेना पड़ेगा इनटू 2π. तो टाइम पीरियड 2π/ओमेगा, मतलब टाइम पीरियड 2π इसका रूट का रेसिप्रोकल. टाइम पीरियड इज 2π/√i अबाउट द इंस्टेंटेनियस एक्सेलरेशन अपॉन mgl. सो दैट इज योर फॉर्मुला. यू शुड नो हाउ टू डिराइव दिस. Deriving this just simply practices finding time period. So you should know how to derive this. And then that said, we should also be able to substitute the value of I and L. So I, known body hoga. You'll have to figure out the moment of inertia of that body above that axis. You should know your standard formulas. You should know your parallel and perpendicular axis theorems. Okay, clearly. And the second thing is L nikalne ke liye you should know where the center of mass lies. Is it a disc? Is it a semicircular disc? Is it a rod? Then you should know where the center of mass lies. Accordingly, center of mass aur uske beech mein distance nikalna padega. And then time period will be 2π/√i/mgl. So iske hum 2-3 question karenge practice karne ke liye. Maybe 2 simple ones and 1 good one. Okay. But at the end of the day, it's going to be more a test of rotational mechanics and center of mass. Do you know where the center of mass is? Do you know your parallel axis theorem well? It's going to be a test of that. Because the SHM part, you just have to plug in those values in this formula. Any doubts? Okay. Yeah. R, what does R donate? Do you know? I think that's an old message, right? Could you repeat how we got omega in the end? So omega, pehle maine torque likha, torque, same story like before, minus mg l theta. Sirf is bar, there's no bob, l is actually distance between center mass and the axis. So torque likha, टॉर्क लिखने के बाद टॉर्क अपॉन मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया इज अल्फा, तो ऐसा अल्फा आ गया. वेन एवर यू गेट अल्फा इन टर्म्स ऑफ थीटा, वहां पे ए इज माइनस ओमेगा स्क्वायर एक्स, यहाँ पे अल्फा इज माइनस ओमेगा स्क्वायर थीटा, सो दिस टर्म इज ओमेगा स्क्वायर. ओके, सो टाइम पीरियड इज 2 पाई बाय ओमेगा, मतलब इसका रूट का रेसिप्रोकल, इसका रूट ओमेगा होगा एंड बाय ओमेगा इसका रेसिप्रोकल होगा, तो रूट का रेसिप्रोकल. कूल, तो लेट्स सी सम एग्जांपल्स. ओके, let me know when you're done. Whoever said wait. Yeah, guys, please write a little faster. Okay? Try writing when I start. Yeah, he said that. Try writing when I start teaching. Yeah, so find the time period. Isme actually, this is rotated like this. Okay, physical pendulum wala context. Isko aisa, aisa aage piche oscillate kara hai. Swing kara hai. साइड टू साइड डिस्क है, सिंपल है, कर लो. नेक्स्ट वन इज गोना बी स्लाइटली टफर. Yeah, nice, guys. Rugved, Yash, say it. Two pi root. Say 2π√ I by MGL. Tanmay say it, Prithviraj say it. I about that axis, L distance or center mass from that axis. Okay, so this one's a slight So it's slightly easier. It's not root 6r by g, and it's not root r by g. Root r by g, I think you found I above the center of mass. I above that. And root 6, I'm not sure. Just cross check. Yes, Deepak say hai, Pratyasha say hai. So in this question, so we need I above the IOR and we need L. If you can find this, you can use the formula. So I above the IOR is basically you'll apply you'll apply parallel axis theorem. You know I above the center of mass. So ICM plus M distance square. See, center of mass distance R ho jayega. So ICM plus MR square. Is I about that IAOR, instantaneous axis of rotation. ICM is MR square by 2 for a disk about its own axis, central axis. So MR square by 2 plus MR square, making it 3 by 2 MR square. Ye wala axis ke baad I chahiye. That's why I specified it in the formula itself, so that you don't, in a haste, find I about any other point you like. It has to be about the axis about which this is rotating. L has to be distance of center of the center mass from that axis, from that point of suspension. So L in this case is very simple. L is simply R. So here say we get time period is 2 pi root. When you plug it in, 3 by 2 MR square for MG R. Making it MG M or R can't do, making it root 3 R by 2 G. See, Amesha and me, ek bar dimensions, agar check lo, is this length by G? 2 pi root L by G pendulum ka hota hai na. So does this look like length by G? And it does. 3 R by 2 G, L by G ke form mein. Okay. Got it? We'll do maybe one tough one and then we'll end on a high note by doing the simple one. Yeah, it's simple wala pehle de. Right. Anyone wants me to wait here, please say so. Hey, do copy quickly. Okay. So, it was simple, then we'll. Yes. R is equal to. L, yes. In that case, R was L. Okay, whatever. So, yape, I have a rod of mass M and length L. Simple. Again, okay, rod of mass. Now, this time, everyone should get rod of mass M, length L, suspended from an edge. Iska time period, jaldi. Yes, then I see it. And Pratyash, Sanika say hai. Prithvi Raj, Purna, Rugved say hai. 2 pi root L by 3 G is wrong. Please check that again. Yash, say here. Okay, one more minute. Okay, so this is ultimately just a test of whether you know the formula. Second, whether you know how to find moment of inertia about some axis. And third, whether you know where the center of mass lies. So far, these two examples, 4 pi root L by 3 G, thoda galat hai. Deepak sahi hai. Just for information, pi is spelled pi, not pie. The same material, but yeah. Root L by 3 G, ek aur 2 pi root L by 3 G, ek aur answer aa raha. That's wrong. It's a silly mistake. Yeah, so let's just see what was the silly mistake. I think you've not taken L correctly. L was not the length of the rod. L in our formula has to be distance of the center of mass from the point of suspension. So apna formula ka L is actually L by 2, half of the length of the rod. Okay? Compound pendulum ke formula mein jo L jayega, that had to be half of the length of the rod. Pratyasha Singh. Okay? And for the first part, okay, this is settled. We know where the center of mass is. It's a uniform rod. For the first part, moment of inertia about the edge of the rod, this is a result we should memorize. This is for someone who didn't know that. You could take I about the center of mass plus m L by 2 ka square, and you get m L square by 3 from there, parallel axis theorem. But this has to be memorized. Okay, this is also a standard result. Rod ka end ke about bhi yaad rehna chahiye. So ml square by 3 above the edge and length is L by 2, substituted 2 pi root I upon mg LCM. Okay, so LCM in this case is L by 2. LCM is L by 2. So making this formula 2 pi root 2 L by 3 G. Okay. Maybe, you know, in case just later on, if you ever make a mistake, just write that formula as the CM dalos. Remember it as LCM. 2 pi root I about IOR upon MG LCM. Where LCM is distance of the center of mass from that point. Okay, nothing here. Done. All right, so now a better question, okay? Again, just the test of whether you guys know how to find moment of inertia, whether you know where the center of mass lies. Let's see this question. So I'm going to quickly... All right, so what you actually have is a semicircular disc. Okay, semicircular disc, find time period, semicircular disc, it's suspended about that point, find the time period, okay, when it is made to oscillate. Semicircular disc ka mass diya hai, radius diya hai. I have actually been kind enough to tell you where the center of mass lies. Now that also something you should be honest with yourself. Did you remember this result? Was it in your memory ki center of mass? Center say 4r by 3 pi upar lie karta hai. Because if you didn't, then you know, if this was in the exam, you wouldn't have been able to start the question itself. So center of mass wale results have to be memorized. Theek hai, I'm kind de diya maine 4r by 3 pi. Ab isse aur aage kahani badhana hai. L nikalo, I nikal do, and write your answer. Okay, you need not type out the answer. If you have a lot of patience, you can type it out. The answer is not going to be something nice and neat. Okay, but at least write that term down, and you can cross check with my answer in the end. Once you've written your answer, don't worry about simplifying it further. Just make sure everything you've done is conceptually correct, and then we can cross check our answers. I'm going to give you guys 3 minutes. Okay, so 20:35, 20:38, 3 minutes. Let's see if you know your parallel axis theorem. One more minute, at least get I. Yeah. If you have I written down, and if you have L written down, then you can just say time period is root 2 pi root I by MGL. At least get I and L. We'll have to check if that answer is correct. Most probably, if you're able to type out that answer and if you're making it look small, most probably it's wrong. So you can just cross-check your answer with mine. Has everyone at least written down moment of inertia? Yeah, I'll wait for some more time. At least I about IOR likh lo. Don't simplify it, at least just write it. Ruk raha hu. One more minute. Here's the one who just messaged me, most probably it's wrong. Just check your I about IOR again. Prithvi, again, most probably wrong, unless you have simplified a lot of terms. Still, I think it's going to be wrong. We'll check. No, Yash, it's not. Yeah, it's good. At least this question will now expose one big conceptual mistake a lot of students make. Yeah, so hopefully with this question, you'll remember that conceptual mistake. Okay. Ready? Sabka, are you ready at least? Yes, Purna, I think Sai Dikra. I think that's, yeah. Dekh lo abhi. Okay. So, kya hai isme? The main challenge, first of all, it lies in L and I. All right. L is quite simple once you know where the center of mass lies. So guys, you have to remember the center of mass results. 2r by pi, 4r by 3 pi, ye sare results tumhe yaad karna hai. Because if you don't know that, the question is lost there itself. Okay? So of course, I I gave it to you this time, but just that's just a reminder. If you didn't know this, today itself, go and memorize the other locations of the center of mass for a cone, hollow cone, solid sphere, sorry, solid hemisphere, hollow hemisphere, you know, disc and semicircular ring. Semicircular disc, semicircular ring. Yes, sir, yaad kar lo. Okay? So you need to know where the center of mass lies, giving you L as, in this case, R minus 4R by 3 pi. So it's R minus this distance. So if you know the formula for the center of mass, you know the value of L. So L is not a challenge. But the moment of inertia about the IAOR, what some of you guys did was, first and foremost, isme kya kya concept hai? Pehle to yaar ye disc ka kitna hota hai, moment of inertia, semicircular disc ka wo bhi kitna hota hai? About the central axis. So the answer is, it's actually mr square by 2. In fact, for any sector, it is mr square by 2. Any sector. Not just the complete disc. Any sector, it is mr square by 2. Don't think that a sector chota hona chahiye because sector is a small part of a circle. Ye wo sector ka mass hai. Jo chota ho raha hai, sector ke saath saath is sector's mass. Okay? Any sector ka moment of inertia is mr square by 2. I hope you guys know this. So any sector, any pizza slice about this center, moment of inertia is mr square by 2. Now, pehle wo ek cheez tha ki wo, knowing that, understanding why that is mr square by 2. Okay, I'm not going to go deep into that. That, of course, you've learned moment of inertia. So, if you know this, ki center ke about mr square by 2 hai, okay, then some of you applied parallel axis theorem. Some of you applied parallel axis theorem in this manner. Hold on. Sab clear ho jayega. Abhi bas sun lo. Some of you applied parallel axis theorem by saying it's mr square by 2 plus mr square. So some of you got I about IOR as 3 by 2 mr square. Yeah, that's of course wrong. In fact, isn't that the moment of inertia for this one over here? Is pure circle ke liye 3 by 2 mr square aa raha hai. Definitely, yaar, usi mass ka agar semicircle lunga, to things have changed. Moment of inertia is not going to be the same. What is the error that is that we guys are doing? Theek hai, to yahan se yahan directly nahi ja sakta. Kyun? Tumhara parallel axis theorem is not, acha ek axis pata hai, dusra axis ke about I chahiye. I2 is I1 plus mr square. That is not a formula. The formula is I is ICM plus mr square. Your starting point always has to be the center of mass. So what do you do? Yes, it's with respect to the center of mass. So if you ever come across a situation like this, where moment of inertia about one axis is known and moment of inertia about another axis is desired and the known axis is not your center of mass wala axis, okay, then what you need to do is you first need to find ICM. How do you do that? Oops. Huh? So first thing is you realize, acha, chalo, I2 is ICM plus MR2 square. Yeh sahi equation hai. Directly mat likho, theek hai? Directly sahi nahi hai. It's wrong. I2 is ICM plus MR2 square. I1 is ICM plus MR1 square. Okay. Now look at the second equation. Second equation ko agar ulta karenge, matlab MR square ko dusre side leke jayenge. Mujhe kya karna hai? Mujhe actually I1 se ICM निकालना है और फिर ICM से I2 निकालना है. तो I1 से ICM कितना आ रहा है? ये आ रहा है. So what is really happening? If I go to the center of mass from another axis, I have to subtract mr square. Okay, this is also consistent with the fact कि center किस axis के about least moment of inertia मिलता है. You guys know the answer to that, है ना? An axis passing through the center of mass about least moment of inertia milta. So this is consistent with that. If you're going to the center of mass, subtract mr square. Okay, if you're going to the center of mass, subtract mr square. If you're moving away from the center of mass, add mr square. So how does this work? ICM is I1 minus mr1 square. So ICM aa gaya. I2 is ICM plus mr2 square. So if you want to write that directly, I2 is I1 minus mr1 square going towards the center of mass plus mr2 square moving away from the center of mass. Okay, so that is how you write your moment of inertia. So if you can think and see what conceptual mistake was made, it's always important to understand the mistake you made and catch that. It's okay to get questions wrong. This is what I say, this is what I mean by analyze your paper, analyze your mistakes. Is it just the calculation mistake or is it something deeper? Because if it's something deeper, you can fix it and you can ensure ki that's not repeated again. You don't fix it, you know, the repetition can be costly. So, kya hai yahan pe? This is the mistake. So, yahan pe mr square by 2 se center of mass jaate waqt hum subtract karenge md square. Mr square by 2 minus md square. Whatever is the distance till the center of mass, wo subtract kiya minus m. 4r by 3 pi square. फिर वहां से और आगे बढ़ते वक्त m d square add करेंगे. Alright, so now the next distance is r minus 4r by 3 pi. तो वो add करेंगे. तो m r minus 4r by 3 pi square add करेंगे. This is moment of inertia about the IOR. ठीक है? And now I'm feeling lazy, so I'm just writing my answer as 2 pi root I by mgl. Yeah, so basically, of course, if you have the answers, you can substitute them and you can get L. Option B aisa bada khasa dikhega. Point is getting these two right. This needs you to apply the effort and remember the formulas. And this needs you to understand parallel axis theorem. Okay. What doubts? Again, one of you is saying, sir, shouldn't ICMB MR square by 2? प्लस एम फोर आर बाई थ्री पाई स्क्वायर. ये तू बता कि ये इक्वेशन सही है. तू बोल, तू बेसिकली बता, बता क्या बोल रहा है. तो बोला आईसीएम शुड बी आई वन प्लस एम आर स्क्वायर. इज दैट द करेक्ट, इज दैट व्हाट यू डिराइव्ड? आईसीएम इज आई वन प्लस एम आर वन स्क्वायर, और हैव यू डिराइव्ड आई वन इज आईसीएम प्लस एम आर वन स्क्वायर? गो बैक एंड लुक एट द डेफिनेशन. द डेफिनेशन, आई मीन गो बैक एंड लुक एट द डेरिवेशन फॉर पैरेलल एक्सिस थ्योरम. यू विल फाइंड कि पैरेलल एक्सिस थ्योरम ऐसा आता है कि I about any axis is ICM plus M distance square, not the other way around. Obviously, out of these two, only one can be correct. तो दूसरा वाला बोल रहा है. You are saying, why isn't ICM MR square by 2 plus M4R by 3 pi square? मतलब you're claiming this. So that means you're claiming this ICM is कोई axis के about moment of inertia plus MR square. इन दोनों में से एक सही होना चाहिए ना. तो ये दूसरा वाला गलत है, पहला वाला सही है. गो बैक एंड लुक एट योर नोट्स, गो बैक एंड सी द डेरिवेशन एंड यू विल बी कन्विंस्ड व्हाई इट इज आई अबाउट एनी एक्सिस इक्वल टू आईसीएम प्लस एमआर स्क्वायर. सो ऑल्सो रिमेंबर कि आई सेंटर ऑफ मास के अबाउट लीस्ट होता है मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया. यू मे प्रोबेबली इवन रिमेंबर दैट एज अ पीस ऑफ ट्रिविया. याद भी रहेगा शायद, सेंटर ऑफ मास के अबाउट लीस्ट होता है, लीस्ट होता है. तो लीस्ट होता है तो सेंटर मास तक जाते वक्त सब्ट्रैक करो, है ना, सब्ट्रैक करो. अगर और कोई पॉइंट पे एमआर स्क्वायर है, सॉरी, अरे यार, अगर और कोई पॉइंट पे एमआर स्क्वायर है तो सेंटर मास में एमआर स्क्वायर से कम होना चाहिए. और कोई पॉइंट, और कोई पॉइंट पे एमआर स्क्वायर बाय 2 है, सेंटर मास पे एमआर स्क्वायर बाय 2 से कम होना चाहिए. ओके, एवरीवन गॉट दिस, अंडरस्टूड? Okay, and again, good job for all those who wrote this directly. I think a couple of you wrote, but I hope the others learned how to correctly apply parallel axis theorem. Especially advanced perspectives, aisa semicircle, circular disc, semicircular ring, vagera aa sakta. Jahan pe actually test kya ho raha hai? Do you know where the center of mass is? And do you know how to apply parallel axis theorem? Okay, the SHM part then is easy. Okay. Done with this page. Any doubts, guys? Okay. All right. So I'll before ending today's class, of course, I'll take some doubts, but I just want to do a little bit of maths. And then we'll take the story ahead. Okay, so just the maths. Iska jo actually, when we talk about combining two SHMs in the same direction, the final result is a very interesting and simple result. But the maths, just to prove it the first time, is slightly lengthy. Now, you need not do this again. Okay, you need not do this while solving any question. But just once and for all, I'm just going to show you the math and so that you understand ki jo bhi hum ant mein shortcut use karenge, wo shortcut aa kahan se raha hai. And if you actually understand this, it may help you in trigonometry as well. Okay, it could help you in maths as well. All right, so let's just see this maths once. Okay? So what we want to do is, we want to understand, okay, ye bas ek bar main bas maths kar raha hu, and then we'll continue the idea in the next class. Okay, so you can just copy this and understand this. Okay. Even if you don't want to copy, it's fine. I mean, if you want to just refer to the, even if you just know the final answer, it's fine. If you don't know the derivation, it's fine. But just understand this once and for all. यहाँ पे क्या है कि मुझे ये equation को थोड़ा और समझना है. ये क्या है? ये ऐसा लग रहा है दो SHM का combination है. Now these are two SHMs in the same direction. Okay, so there is a force which wants to make a particle move like this. Another force which wants to make the particle move like this. So इनका combination के कारण particle कैसा मूव करेगा इज द क्वेश्चन. ओके, सो नाउ दीज टू SHMs हैव डिफरेंट एम्पलीट्यूड्स, दे हैव द सेम फ्रीक्वेंसी. ओके, ऑल ऑफ दिस इज बेस्ड ऑन देम हैविंग द सेम ओमेगा. इफ दे डोंट हैव द सेम ओमेगा, वी कांट, द मोशन, रिजल्टिंग मोशन विल बी वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स, नॉट बी नाइस एंड रेपिटेटिव. ओके, एंड यहाँ पे लेट्स से डेल्टा इज द फेज डिफरेंस बिटवीन देम. नाउ लेट्स सी व्हाट वी कैन डू विद दिस. तो पहले मैं क्या कर रहा हूँ, पहले मैथमेटिकली इसको खोल रहा हूँ, साइन ए प्लस बी का फॉर्मूला लगा रहा हूँ. तो हो जाएगा बी साइन ओमेगा टी कॉस डेल्टा प्लस बी साइन डेल्टा कॉस ओमेगा टी. दैट इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप. आई ओपन द ब्रैकेट्स ऑफ द सेकेंड टर्म. द नेक्स्ट थिंग वी आर गोइंग टू डू इज, यू कैन सी टू साइन ओमेगा टी टर्म्स and then one cos omega t term, so we are going to club the sin omega t terms. Okay, and similarly we will write the cos omega t terms separately. So sin omega t agar main common lunga to aa jayega a plus b cos delta sin omega t b sin delta cos omega t. So aise do term hai. Now a plus b cos delta is actually a constant. A and b are amplitudes. Delta is a fixed phase. It's the phase at the beginning, t equal to zero wala phase. Iska. So delta is also constant. It's called as phase constant. So a plus b cos delta a constant ho gaya. Jisko hum x bolenge. I'm giving it the name x. B sine delta a constant ho gaya. Jisko naam y de diya. Yes, Prithvi, that's correct. Good. तो x a plus b cos delta को x बोल दिया और b sin delta को y बोल दिया. ठीक है, नाम दिया है जस्ट टू मेक आवर लाइफ सिंपल. समटाइम्स इन मैथ्स वी सब्स्टिट्यूट कॉम्प्लेक्स थिंग्स एज सिंपलर थिंग्स सो दैट वी कैन ऑब्जर्व अ लिटिल बेटर व्हाट्स रियली गोइंग ऑन. सो नाउ माय इक्वेशन लुक्स अ लिटिल बेटर, लुक्स लाइक दिस. नाउ दिस माइट लुक फेमिलियर टू यू बिकॉज इन मैथ्स यू हैव फाउंड द max value of this function. You know the max value of this function is root x square plus y square. Hai na? You've seen how the max value for this function is derived. And there are many ways to derive this. Different ways. But one of the ways we derive the max value of this function is ki we multiply and divide by root x square plus y square. You might have seen your teacher do that. We multiply, divide by root x square plus y square. Kya hota hai? मल्टीप्लाई डिवाइड करके रूट एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर देख लेते हैं. तो मान लो ऐसा मैंने रूट एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर मल्टीप्लाई किया, ठीक है, तो ये बाहर लिख रहा हूँ और इंडिविजुअली दोनों से डिवाइड किया तो उसको मैंने ऐसा अंदर लिखा, ठीक है. नाउ व्हेन वी लुक एट दिस टर्म, ठीक है, अब इसका करने का पर्पस ये था, ये जो टर्म है, ये दोनों जो टर्म है अगर तुम ध्यान से देखोगे इनको अगर स्क्वायर करके एड करोगे यू गेट वन. इसका स्क्वायर ले लो यू गेट एक्स स्क्वायर अपॉन एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर. और इसका स्क्वायर ले लो तो यू गेट वाई स्क्वायर अपॉन एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर एंड इफ यू एड देम यू गेट वन. सो वी हैव क्रिएटेड टू टर्म्स ओवर हियर जिनका स्क्वायर का सम इज वन. क्यों किया है थोड़ी देर में दिखेगा, है ना. समटाइम्स दीज मैथमेटिशियंस हैव अ लिटिल फोरसाइट, आगे का दिखता है. समटाइम्स वी सी ओनली वन स्टेप एट अ टाइम. मैथ्स रिक्वायर्स यू टू सी अ फ्यू स्टेप्स अहेड. तो इन सम टाइम यू सी क्यों किया ये. तो यहाँ पे ये दोनों टर्म का स्क्वायर का सम वन है, मतलब वन टर्म कैन बी कॉल्ड एज साइन ऑफ सम एंगल, अदर टर्म कैन बी कॉल्ड एज अ कॉस ऑफ दैट सेम एंगल ना. बिकॉज इफ टू टर्म्स का स्क्वायर का सम इज वन, देन वन टर्म कैन बी रिटन एज साइन थीटा, द अदर कैन बी रिटन एज कॉस थीटा. तो यहाँ पे वही किया मैंने, मैंने इस टर्म को कॉस एप्साइलन बोल दिया और इस टर्म को साइन एप्साइलन नाम दे दिया. क्यों, उनका स्क्वायर का सम वन है, देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम. ओके नाउ ठीक है, देयर डेफिनेटली देयर मैग्नीट्यूड इज लेस विद इन वन एंड माइनस वन, डिनोमिनेटर इज ऑलवेज बिगर. ठीक है, देयर मैग्नीट्यूड इज विद इन वन एंड माइनस वन, तो साइन एप्साइलन कॉस एप्साइलन बोलना सही. तो अब देखो ये करके दिस स्टार्ट्स टू लुक लाइक दिस, रूट एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर cos epsilon sin omega t plus sin epsilon cos omega t. Now that looks nice and familiar. That seems like sin a plus b ka expansion. In fact, that is exactly the expansion of sin omega t plus epsilon. That's the expansion of sin omega t plus epsilon. Okay. So this is once and for all just showing you the procedure, mathematical procedure. Good news is we won't have to do all of this again. Because this result is a little interesting. First and foremost, this result is an SHM. Okay, this is an SHM. This is some number amplitude into sine omega t plus some initial phase. So this is an SHM. So we have proved ki koi bhi do SHM of the same frequency ko agar add karoge, we again get an SHM. That's what we have proved. Okay, we again get an SHM. हाँ, एम्पलीट्यूड अलग हो जाता है और ये फेज भी अलग हो जाता है, बट वी गेट एन एसएचएम. अब एम्पलीट्यूड क्या हो जाता है उसको थोड़ा ध्यान से देखते हैं. लेट्स सी इफ देयर इज एनीथिंग इंटरेस्टिंग. तो एम्पलीट्यूड इज रूट एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर. ओके, सो इधर साइड में लिख रहा हूं. अब एक्स और वाई सब्स्टिट्यूट करो तो एक्स इज ए प्लस बी कॉस डेल्टा, वाई इज बी साइन डेल्टा. दिस शुड ऑलरेडी स्टार्ट टू लुक अ लिटिल फेमिलियर. In fact, if I square both of these, I get a square, फिर b square cos square delta and b square sin square delta club होके b square हो जाएगा. And फिर इसके square के expansion में एक और term बाकी है, 2ab cos delta. In fact, what is this? Where have we seen this before? Right? Parallelogram law में this is, in fact, this is the result. This is the formula for the addition of two vectors. रिजल्टेंट का मैग्नीट्यूड का फॉर्मूला है, सी दैट इन पैरेललोग्राम लॉ. तो रूट ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर प्लस टू ए बी कॉस डेल्टा आ गया इसका एम्पलीट्यूड. यानी कि दिस लुक्स सिमिलर टू वेक्टर एडिशन समहाउ. दिस एस एच एम इफ यू ट्रीट दैट एज अ वेक्टर ऑफ मैग्नीट्यूड ए एंड यू ट्रीट दिस एज अ वेक्टर ऑफ मैग्नीट्यूड बी एंड यू से कि इनके बीच में जो फेज डिफरेंस है या तो डेल्टा है, उस फेज डिफरेंस को एंगुलर सेपरेशन के तरह ट्रीट करोगे तो यू गेट दिस फॉर्मूला फॉर द रिजल्टेंट ऑफ दोज टू वेक्टर्स एंड दैट रिजल्टेंट का मैग्नीट्यूड इज एक्चुअली रिजल्टेंट एसएचएम का एम्पलीट्यूड. सो आई विल ऑफकोर्स गो ओवर दी सिमिलैरिटीज एंड गो ओवर द शॉर्टकट इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. बट व्हाट वी आर जस्ट प्रूविंग ओवर हियर इज नाउ नेक्स्ट टाइम वी डोंट हैव टू डू ऑल ऑफ दिस मैथ्स. यहाँ पे जो रिजल्ट आ रहा है वो एकदम वेक्टर की तरह ही दिख रहा है, वेक्टर एडिशन की तरह हो गया. सो देयर इज अ वे कि वी कैन अवॉइड ऑल ऑफ दिस मैथ्स बिकॉज़ वी आर वेरी कंफर्टेबल विद वेक्टर्स. द फर्स्ट चैप्टर वी डिड, है ना, एंड वी विल ट्रीट दीज टू एसएचएम्स एज टू वेक्टर्स, इमेजिनरी वेक्टर्स, एंड उनका उनको एड करके जो रिजल्टेंट आएगा उस रिजल्टेंट से हम ये जो रिजल्टेंट एसएचएम है निकालेंगे. So that is what is in store for the next class. This looks like the addition of two vectors. Okay, wo similarity yahan pe dikh raha hai. Moreover, if I try to understand this angle epsilon, so if you see this And if you divide sine by cos, you get tan epsilon as baki katega y by x. So tan epsilon is y by x, making epsilon tan inverse y by x, and go substitute y, you get b sine delta upon a plus b cos delta. This also should look familiar. Maybe not that much, not as familiar as this, but this is also familiar. Hena, isn't this the angle the resultant makes with the vector a? Ye formula was the angle the resultant makes with vector a. And yahan pe, interestingly, this is the phase difference the final SHM makes with the first SHM. Inke beech mein phase difference, andar ek mein omega t, dusre mein omega t plus epsilon. So inke beech mein phase difference epsilon hai. And this is, if you compare this, this is like the angle between the resultant and the vector a. So phase difference is behaving like angle. Phase difference is behaving like angle, and amplitude is somehow behaving like the magnitude. And I will formalize that analogy in the next class, and we learn how to easily just combine SHMs. Okay? Reality is this. This is technically how SHMs would have been combined. But since we are familiar with vectors, we immediately spot a similarity, and we will now combine vectors using that vector analogy. So that's what we're going to do on Friday. So with that, Friday, we'll more or less, I think we'll finish vectors. And then I'll keep next week to discuss some, you know, interesting, better questions on SHM. There's no limit to what kind of question can be created. Whole variety can be created. So maybe we'll devote the next week, two lectures to practice that. All right. Yeah, anyone wants to ask any doubt, you can do so. Prithvi. Friday. I meant, come on, we are meeting on Thursday. Thursday ko ho jayega. Extra lecture ka zarur nahi hai. Thursday ko, when we meet, sab ho jayega. Prithvi, tu jo bol raha hai, sahi hai, bilkul. Correct. Sahi. Very nice. नहीं एक मिनट एक मिनट एक मिनट एक्स ना एक्स है ना कहाँ पे है यार एक्स बी कॉस डेल्टा आई कैप एंड वाई इज बी साइन थीटा जे कैप साइन डेल्टा जे कैप जस्ट चेक दैट अगेन या आयुष वेट आई जस्ट अलाउ यू गाइस टू अनम्यूट you guys can unmute.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, am I audible?
Yes.
Sir, I just wanted to ask whether base and its branches, the several centers located across the city, whether they provide the enrollment form for PRMO and other national Olympiads organized by IAPT.
You'll have to check with your center managers. I'm not very, I mean, they're the ones who are aware of the answers to all these queries. Jada idea.
Okay,
so whoever's the head of your WhatsApp group, no, you can just ask them, and they know who to contact for this. Either they'll help you give you the forms itself, or they'll help you with that procedure.
Okay, sir. I was just curious because I did some research of my own and found that PACE, Andheri, the main branch, and several other branches are registered examination centers for PRMO and other exams.
Could be.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
You can cross check that with your.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Yeah. Good night, sir.
Good night. Haan, Prithvi, pooch sakta hai. And Kushal. Is it advisable to solve previous year questions more than reference questions? See, Kushal, thing is, if it's your first time learning a chapter, do it from a good reference book, which will take you. Because first time learning a chapter, the exam is not important. The concepts are important. So you need to learn the concept in a structured way. First time learning, solve from your from any book which seems structured. So like HCV or DC Pandey or some, you know, anything which seems structured. Second, solving revision tum kahin se bhi kar sakte ho. Revision, if you want to do from an additional booklet or you want to do past year papers, that's all fine. And that's revision. But first learning ek sahi jagah se kar lo, tab ek to class mein samajh mein aata hai, but खुद का एक अंडरस्टैंडिंग जब खुद से डिस्कवर करोगे, खुद से क्वेश्चन सॉल्व करके, यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट्स अ डिफरेंट थिंग. दैट्स व्हेन यू रियली अंडरस्टैंड. सो फॉर दैट यू नीड अ बुक विच टेक्स यू थ्रू कॉन्सेप्ट्स इन अ राइट वे. सम बुक्स कैन हैव अ गुड कलेक्शन ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, बट देन यू नो दे डोंट रियली टेस्ट ऑल द कोर कॉन्सेप्ट्स एंड दे डोंट स्ट्रक्चर इट वेल. सो इट्स जस्ट अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ गुड क्वेश्चंस. तो ऐसा पास के पेपर्स देखो तो मिक्स बैग होगा. डोंट डू दैट फॉर अ न्यू चैप्टर. बट ओल्ड चैप्टर्स में हीट थर्मो करना है तो यू नो दोस चैप्टर्स एंड ऑल ऑप्टिक्स वगैरह यू कैन फॉर दैट यू कैन डू पास पेपर्स. दैट्स फाइन.
ओके सर, थैंक यू सर.
वेलकम. हां पृथ्वी.
सर इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 28
एक मिनट बुक लाता हूं. Is that the one you posted on the group?
Yes, sir.
वो कुछ तो spring and wall का.
हाँ, sir, I understood why the time period of the spring was given as that and like the answer. So, but for the block, sir, why will it go for an SHM once it collides with the wall towards the left?
Who said it's an SHM? Who said it's an SHM?
Sir, but the answer, the video solution, sir, that you sent, the person said that the block which is not attached to the spring, it also goes for an SHM and the total time taken is 2L by V.
Eh? Yeah. Ek minute, 28.
Yes, sir.
28. Yeah, 28. Let me just read that once. Left block moves at speed V towards the right. All collisions take place. I show the motions are periodic. So it's not an SHM. It's a, the motion will be harmonic motion.
Okay. Will sir, be in harmonic. Yes, sir. I might have misunderstood.
So it's not going to be an SHM, but it's definitely periodic. Because you know, you can clearly see ki. ये पोर्शन तो पीरियोडिक होता है. यहाँ से जाके वापस आने का टाइम होता है हाफ ऑफ योर टाइम पीरियड.
तो यस दिस पार्ट आई अंडरस्टूड
एंड द अदर पार्ट इज जस्ट काइनेमैटिक्स.
सो देन व्हाई विल इट बी 2L सर? इट शुड बी L बाय V नो?
अरे जाके आना है ना
सर. वो L बाय 2 आगे जाएगा एंड देन अगेन
L जाएगा. ये L है. This is a frictionless floor. वो जाके वॉल को हिट करके वापस लौटेगा. 2L distance cover करेगा with a speed v.
सर तो इसके सर एक पीरियड में वो स्टार्ट करेगा सर L by 2 distance पे सर जैसे डायग्राम में दिया है.
नहीं अच्छा डायग्राम में यार वो डायग्राम जैसे ऐसे ही रैंडमली दिखा है. वो तो जो भी हो स्टार्ट किया इधर पहुंच गया यहाँ से आगे ट्रेस कर ले है ना. तो यहाँ से यहाँ जाके पाई बाई रूट m बाई k होगा और फिर ये पूरा एक यहाँ से यहाँ आने के लिए 2L बाई v होगा.
ओके सर इतना ही डाउट था. एंड सर 29th वाले में सर द हाइट फॉर द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड स्लोप इज गिवन एज 10 सेंटीमीटर.
हाँ
एंड दे सेड दैट टू एंड फॉर द एनर्जी टू बी कंजर्व द बॉल विल गो फॉर टू अ हाइट ऑफ 10 सेंटीमीटर फॉर द सेकंड स्लाइड एज वेल.
यस
Sir, I didn't know. I didn't get that. Why 10 centimeters on the right hand side?
So what do you think? It should be more or less.
Sir, I don't know why. No idea.
See, energy conserve karna hai. We are assuming there is no loss of energy anywhere. Okay. So if energy is conserved, if over here at some point it is at rest. It rises to some height over here and there as well it is at rest. So then kinetic energy in both situations is the same. So potential energy in both situations should be the same. ताकि टोटल एनर्जी सेम रहेगा, है ना। तो यहाँ पे जो भी पोटेंशियल एनर्जी है वहां पे उतना ही पोटेंशियल एनर्जी होना चाहिए, सो दैट योर टोटल एनर्जी इज द सेम।
सर आई डिड नॉट टेक के फाइनल एज जीरो, आई थॉट इट विल हैव सम वेलोसिटी व्हेन इट रीचेस दैट पॉइंट।
नहीं, इफ टॉप पॉइंट पे तो जीरो होगा ना, if it has velocity is going to rise further, wherever it stops at least there k has to be zero.
Okay sir, then it will come back again. Okay sir, got it. Thank you sir.
Welcome. Bye, good night.